Hey, on this video we're going to improve the system we did on the first video of this tutorial series of the point and click movement system. Now we will deal with blocking the clicks on the UI elements like these buttons and selecting and switching between two units. So let's get started. This scene for this second tutorial has the same elements of the first one, but now we have a units manager where our units are our child of this manager, and this manager is the one that will handle the input. We have an improved input script and also an improved camera script, because now we have to follow the movement of different units depending of which one is selected. Also we have a canvas with two buttons, check it out, one for selecting each of the units we have. So now that we know the new elements of our scene, let's check out the scripts we have, the change or improvements we have to do to the scripts to be able to handle two different units. On the new camera script, we only need to add a reference to the transform of the second unit the camera is going to be following when that unit is selected. And as you can see, we have two conditionals for each of the units, and depending on which conditional evaluates to true, the camera will follow the selected unit. And the script that handles which unit is selected is the new input script. The first two new things that we have on the input script are these two lines of code, because we need the namespaces of the UnityEngine.EventSystem. This will allow us to check the raycast on the UI elements. If we don't, this is to use a method that allows us to check if the raycast that goes from the camera to the terrain isn't going through a element of the UI like a button. This is a very common problem that this kind of movement system has, but I will show you how to deal with that problem. And the second line of code is the UnityEngine.UI, just to have the namespaces of all the UI related stuff. Now, for the variables of this script, we had the pointer, the reference to the movement script, and the reference to the cursor of the single unit we had before. Now we have two, so we have cursor 2 and second movement script and a second pointer. And the other thing we notice in these variables of this script is that we have now an enumeration that allows us to easily keep track of which of the units is selected. Let's see that on the editor. See, this is now the object that holds the input script. This selected here is that enumeration. It's like a Boolean structure, but it only that this variable, the selected key variable, can only have one of these two values true at a single time. So if I add more values to this, unit 3, unit 4, and save it, we can see how the enumeration is going to change once it loads. It load and it loaded. So here we have. This is very, very, very handy when we have to deal with things like state machines, where only one state has to be true at a single time. And in this case, only one unit can be selected at a single time. This is much better than using booleans to track which unit is selected. And the last thing we have in the variables of our improved input script are some text variables. These texts are components of the buttons of the UI. These, let me just click them here. So the hierarchy window tells us which text I'm talking about are the texts of the buttons of the UI. You can see it right here. Text of gear 1 and text of unit 2. I just have those in the script to give the player a visual view of which unit is selected. See how the text changed from black to white depending on which unit is selected. That's what they are there. So let's continue with the script. As before, the first thing it does is to get the input from the player, the left click or fire one. But now the new thing is this conditional over here. This conditional evaluates to false when the mouse pointer is over an element of the UI, like a button. Let me just demonstrate this. If I click on the gear 2 button, it just selects the unit of the button. Here I select the second unit, here I select the first unit. Now, let's see if I this conditional, and if I do this, it's like that conditional doesn't even exist. So let's see what happens now. If I run the scene and I have the first unit selected and I try to select the second one, it's going to move down there. See, the button is not blocking the right casting from the camera. So I select the first one, but that's not good. I need to block the right casting from the camera if the cursor or the mouse is over an UI element or an element of the UI. So that is what this conditional does. Uncomment this. And so event system.current.isPointer over game object. This only refers to the game objects that are part of the event system or the UI system. Anyway, if the script follows as before, cast a ray from the camera, checks if this is entered the terrain, and now the second new part of the script is that it has to know which of the units is selected and move only that unit. Here we have a switch statement, and the inside of the cases of that switch statement is the same movement input that our last script. The content of the cases is the same. The position in X and Z axis, give it of the recasting hit, give it to the pointer of the gear that we want to move, of the unit we want to move, and then evaluate if the distance between the pointer, the pointer distance and the unit distance is big enough for it to move, etc, etc, etc. But as I said, now that we have an enumeration that allows script or system to understand which unit is selected, we can use a select case with our selected gear variable that is an enumeration, and that way the game knows which unit to move. So now we need to get something else. We need to see the code that allows us to select one unit or the other. As you can see, I can select it select them not only through the UI buttons, but clicking on the units themselves in the map. So let's take a look at that. At the end of the movement input script, we have two functions. Select one that this function selects the first unit, and select two, a function that selects the second unit. The two functions are basically the same function, but this one turns the text of the first button white and the text of the second button black, and vice versa on the second function. And this is the function that changed the value of my selected care variable. So what do we do with this function that are just in here? They are not nowhere to be seen in the code, in the rest of the code, because we don't call or use these functions from the code. We use these functions from the buttons. As you can see, the two buttons of the canvas, the UI, let me get to this, there we are. In the buttons, we have the onClick event, and here we have the units manager, which is the object that has the movement, the move input script, and we call that script, and in that script we select the function we want to execute when we click that button. So this here in the inspector, in the button component of the button element of the UI, is the one that allows you to execute these pieces of code. This and this one for the other button. As you can see, the button for the second unit has same reference to the unit manager or for the same script, but it has the select to function. So when we click on this button, we get the select one function, we execute the select one function, and when we click on this button, we get the select the second unit function. Okay, now one last thing to do. As you can see, I can select the units with the big buttons of the UI, but not only that, I can also select the units by clicking over them, by clicking on them in the map, in the terrain, in the scene. See, I can select them with the buttons and select them by clicking them. How do we do that? Very easy. First, we have to go to the unit itself, and we have to add a component called event trigger. You can add event triggers like this, add component. You go to events, and here is the event trigger component. In this event trigger component, you need to add an event, a new event. And I don't want to. I already have one. And it's the same thing like the buttons. You select the script where the function you want to execute is the input script. And we need to assign the function that we want to be executing when we click this. So it's that simple to add the UI functionality to the objects on your scene. Oh, by the way, for this to work, your camera needs to have a physics raycaster. This component needs to be present in your camera or it won't detect the event on your on the objects that are in your scene. If I activate the physics raycaster, then I can select the units by clicking their models. So that's it. Wait, the event we are adding is the click. Click event, pointer click. That's it. That's everything we need to add to handle more than one unit with the point and click movement system we did on the first tutorial. So if you have any question, let them in the comments below, in the comment section below. And thanks for watching this tutorial. Goodbye.